Howdy, partners, and welcome to San Francisco, California. We're here inside of the Ghirardelli Square on the Bay City. Excited to bring you another video. Thank you for coming back to my channel. And with that, we're going to dive right into some of the things you need to know before you come and visit San Francisco, California. And the first thing for me that you need to know is that San Francisco is bigger than you think it is. It's about a 7x7 square mile city, which is walkable, right? And you can get around, but it will take you a little longer to get from point to point than you think. It is a little bit of a ways to go from, say, Fisherman's Wharf all the way over to the Golden Gate Park. And inside of that and getting around, there is a lot of hills and there's a lot of walking involved. It is a very hilly city. If you think that it's going to be for the faint of heart, your heart is going to be pumping going up some of these hills, trying to make it to some of these places that you want to see when you want to go see the Painted Ladies, right? And you're coming all the way down there west of Union Square, or whenever you want to go all the way to the tip top here in the Fisherman's Wharf section of San Francisco. There's going to be a ton of hills and walking. It's going to be a lot of work if you're not going to take advantage of the public transportation, which is the number two thing that I want to let you know today, is the public transportation here is fairly good. I would rate it probably an 8 out of 10. If you're from a place like Texas with zero public transportation, it's phenomenal. If you're from a place like London or New York, it might be a little bit lacking in certain spots, but you can usually get around everywhere you need to go on the public transport, whether that be light rail, train, or the famous cable cars, which I would make sure just like not to miss it. Right now they're free while we're here, but usually they're really low cost, and it's just a really cool way to go up some of these famous hills, right, over by Chinatown, over in Union Square, right, and to be able to check that out in an old school, old fashioned way that has been done that way for so long. And you'll see the guys on there, one on the brake and one on the gas, basically, getting you to where you need to go, hop on, hop off service. Really, really cool. But between those ways and the buses, which are very clean and very good, I will say that about the public transport, it's very clean. You can usually get around to where you need to go. While you're getting around to where you need to go, brings us into the third thing that you need to know here in San Francisco, is about the weather, right? I think when you're here in the summertime, be sure to dress in layers, right? And really that will kind of go to all year long, is that you need to wear layers because it's going to be sunny at points, and then that summer fog is going to come in and it's like an air conditioner for the city. It's going to get way colder and you're going to be wanting to take your jacket on and off. Light jacket is probably going to be great for you, but don't be shocked whenever you come here and it's in the middle of August and the temperature is only about 65 degrees outside. And while you have that 65 degree weather, know that there's a ton of things for you to enjoy outside, whether that's you hiking to the exact right spot to get your picture with the Golden Gate Bridge to make all of your friends jealous, or going to the Golden Gate Park, right, and enjoying the big wooded park and things like Japanese Tea Garden inside, or the Dutch windmills all the way to the end, or maybe you're into surfing and you wanna go into the beaches here, of which the water is very cold. So I haven't really seen anybody doing anything other than surfing in the water, but you can be on the beach and you could even enjoy a bonfire or just walking along the beach. Know that you're gonna have really cool weather, even in the summer, to be outside and to be enjoying some of these and even other locations here in the city in an outdoors kind of way, where you can walk around, utilize that public transport that we kind of talked about, and make sure that you're having the very best time possible, because that's such a big part of what it means to be here in San Francisco. Definitely not a place to sit around inside, but to be enjoying the outdoors and the areas around here as well. Inside of some of the outdoor activities, there are a couple I really want to highlight to you and make sure that you spend some time on when you come here to San Francisco. One is to go and see the sea lions over on Pier 39. It is absolutely free. It's in the Fisherman's Wharf part of town. All you need to do is walk over there. Know that during the summer, there's going to be less sea lions, right, than there is in the winter, as some of them migrate away, but you can see them pretty much full time. I know my wife and I took some time in the morning to go around even 6:30 a.m. and we got some really great time with them. It was can be a little bit touristy as you get later in the day and that whole pier kind of packs out with people. But when you're there that early in the morning, you pretty much avoid all of that. We had some time where it was even just the two of us hanging out with the sea lions, listening to all those sounds. Highly, highly recommended. It's one of the cooler things to me that's part of San Francisco, having that coexistence of people and sea lions over on Pier 39. And the second thing to talk about, which you can't miss with any guide for San Francisco, is Alcatraz Island State Penitentiary. Now it's a national park, right? And there's a whole enormous history, which we won't go into too much. It was definitely worth the price of admission to me. Make sure to book your tickets way in advance. You'll go on a ferry. Ferry goes to the island and from it every single day. It is, as well, some hiking on the island. As you can tell, it's got some steep hills, but there's so much inside of there, from the Native American takeover of the island, all the way back to using it as a military prison, and then even, of course, a very famously imprisoning the top inmates in the United States for a period of time. Very, very interesting, and the best part about it is you could kind of come and go as you please once you're on the island. You can catch any ferry off the island, and so you can take your time as much or as little as you want whenever you go to Alcatraz. It also, don't miss some stunning views you can get of the Bay Area from the island while you're there. There are definitely some spots there you can get some awesome photos and video of as well. Outside of that, guys, what I can tell you about San Francisco is it's a sleepy town vibe for me. You kind of expect, or at least I did, it to be a little bit more robust, busy, lots of people, lots of commerce, and it was really been anything but that. It's been very sleepy. It has been very docile and desolate. It has not been packed at all in the places that we've been going, and the whole city pretty much shuts down by about 8 p.m. every day, and there's just not many things that are open later than that right now, which is really interesting because you kind of equate it in my mind to being more of a busy, robust place, and it is absolutely anything but that. So do enjoy the outside parts of it, but also know that if you're trying to do things at 10:30 at night, it's just not going to be. Even some of the basic stores, McDonald's, Starbucks, things, places like that, some of those places are closing at 7, 8 o'clock here inside of the Bay City. So be ready for that and just be aware. While you're dealing with a sleepy city, though, know that it is definitely a foodie city. And one of my biggest takeaways is the pride that so many of the food places here take into the plating of the food. You're going to have, as well, some of the best Asian food here, just based on geographically where it's at. Don't miss that at all, but know that if you take some time, and I'll link down in the description below a few of my favorite places without going into too many of them, enjoy the food here. Know if there's one type of food I can talk about, it is the sourdough mecca of the world. And one of the things that everybody here has to try is the little sourdough bowl, right? And they put in the soft crab inside of the bowl, right, as like a soup. And it's absolutely fantastic. So nowhere in the world will you enjoy sourdough bread more than you will here. I promise you that, even if you're trying to avoid it. But do get it with Dungeness crab. And there's all kinds of places, which I can link some of my favorites below for that as well. But trust me, you won't be able to miss it once you're here. That brings us to the ninth thing that I want you to know, which is to talk about Chinatown. And that's something you absolutely cannot miss while you're here in San Francisco. Is the Chinatown is not only the largest in the Western Hemisphere, but it is also the oldest Chinatown in the Western Hemisphere. And so there's so much history packed into that small location. It's just in the northeastern portion of the San Francisco Bay Area, but there's so much to do and the shops are packed so tight, right? It's like you're in a whole different city inside of a city. Which you can't always say for every single Chinatown you go into, but this one is absolutely unique. So go and check out the Dragon's Gate and go and check out the open air markets there and browse along. Go and check out a few of the different boba tea shops and ramen shops and noodle shops, right? And just about anything under the sun. While you're enjoying your Dungeness crab in Fisherman's Wharf, right, make sure to not miss some of the most authentic Chinese food that you can get inside of Chinatown here in San Francisco. Also take in the history. It's a very interesting place that I can't possibly recommend more. It is easily within walking distance, and you can make that a part of your trip from Union Square, from Fisherman's Wharf, anywhere around the city. Public transportation runs right through it, and then you can step off onto foot to enjoy everything it has. Which brings me to the final thing that I want you to know about San Francisco is that it is also drivable to many different locations, right? One of the first ones that people come to think of course, is Napa Valley, and you can drive. That's what my wife and I chose to do, is to rent a car and to drive up to Napa, which is about an hour drive. You can also take a ferry over across the bay and then take an Uber for about 25, 26, 30 bucks, just depending on the time of day, over to Napa Valley from where the ferry lets off on that side of the bay. I would say that when you're in Napa as well, it's really a good thing to have a car, because it's not like winery. That's all in walking distance. You'll need to either continue Ubering yourself around, or you will have to drive from winery to winery if you do want to do multiple tastings. Of course, there's a really nice town associated as well, and downtown Napa is a really quaint and cute place at that. You also are in driving distance places like San Jose and Oakland as well, and Sausalito, which is right across the bay as well. There's public transportation options for each one. You do start to get long in the tooth on the bus, so know that there's a few other places you can drive to if you want a vacation to more than just the San Francisco itself. You can enjoy these areas going around the bay, and I will say that the drive, if you do take it, is very scenic along the way. With that said, guys, we really rate San Francisco. It has been a low-key trip for us. Enjoyed a ton of food options, right? Enjoyed a lot of scenery and the differences in San Francisco from what we thought to what it is. So if you're from here, you've been here, and we missed something, drop it down in the comments below. If not, thank you so much for being on another one of my videos, guys. Hit a like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more, and we'll look forward to seeing you in the next video.